I think FaZe has the best chance to cause this upset on. I mean, this is a map they've had very good results on in the past. And actually, right off the bat, Envy just taking mid control so quickly. Essentially just two-man rush, three-man rush. It's going to be a split towards the safe bomb site, and it's that retake strategy from the defense again.
Yep, we saw this in the last match as well. Is it going to pay off for the tease as it did for NIP against Lounge Gaming? So far, so good for FaZe. His brain will chime out with the first frag. That being said, though, MBK has pushed so aggressively through highways on the truck right now. He's looking for those headshots, runs out of bullets. 20 bullets, not enough in the Glock. And he gets silenced as well from Jacob. Here's another one tap, this time from Kiyoshima. And that leaves Happy in a 1v4. He has burst out from highway, but the Glock certainly not as good as the USPs at this kind of range. And it will expectedly be the defuse.
Yeah, it looked good initially for Envy. They got into the site. They didn't really meet with any resistance in mid. They did lose a player, but once they actually got into the A bomb site, that was just so disjointed. We had a couple players pushing towards truck, couple people trying to get in this bomb site to protect the planner. It just seemed very, very disorganized there from Envy. And this might be something that we can look forward to. Maybe not look forward to, but something we expect to see as this match goes on. Is sometimes these matches, while they're not like the best Counter-Strike to look at from a theoretical aspect, they just become slugfest, and that's kind of what I expect this to turn into at a certain point.
Absolutely. I think it will be the polar opposite of what we saw in the last match, which was just very steady, methodical, almost surgical precision from NIP on the T side. I think we'll see more explosions.
The orchestra that Threat conducted.
Exactly.
We're not expecting that whatsoever.
Was pretty beautiful. That being said, here comes the charge out of the blue door, Squeaky. And FaZe with the M4. Probably will feel like he should have done better from that position. Only gets the one frag, so there are casualties being exchanged between the two teams. And again, it's Happy this time in a 1v3, but as opposed to the pistols, it is two assault rifles and the UMP. The bomb down on a site. Maybe hoping that FaZe walk into a trap here.
This is the one thing you can hope for. Just bide his time, be patient. All the timing of that. That's gotta hurt if you're Happy.
Dunked. That's going to sting.
Because that was the one thing with that much time on the clock. Just sit and wait, see if someone walks into your crosshair. You know, low chance of actually winning that round, but do some economic damage. Maybe you find some way to pull off a miracle, but either way, doesn't work out for him there. 2-0 for FaZe, and it's going to have to be a full save from Envy. They upgrade some pistols. They have one flashbang onto Happy. See what they can do. Try and get into the bomb site and get a plant down.
That is pretty much the plan now from Envious, especially considering they did go for some pistol upgrades. Again, a lot of teams would think about maybe just completely tapping out of this round, but not Envious, as they were talking about on the desk before. MBK could be taking point for his team. The flashbang lands right in the face of Rain, but he's just on the outskirts of the smoke. He's now going to use that to his advantage. Only the one kill again. Probably could have got a couple kills for his troubles, but the bomb has been planted. So indeed, they have met the criteria that they set for themselves, and Apex now has an M4 in his hands as well.
It's a nice nade from Kyo to open things up, but there's still the M4 in play for Envy, and it's boosted on Apex, but he misses the shot. AZ takes him out with a nice shot from the OP. A second one as well, so looked okay for Envy. Looked like they had a chance to pull that in their favor, but FaZe recovered nicely, although it was a little scary. Rain all alone at that A bomb site, that aggressive.
Mm-hmm.
Not a good place to lose that M4. Could have been much, much worse.
I think the flash partially wrecked Envious as well, because he's on the outskirts of the smoke, but you saw two or three players rushing in, pretty much with no vision, so I feel they probably would have checked that spot. But regardless, they get the round. Envious, with those bomb plants, able to afford a comfortable AWP and AKs and a healthy dose of grenades as well. So the first true test for FaZe coming up now. And again, it looks like Envious will be filtering towards the A side of the map for the time being.
Yeah, Kenny's not going to be boosted up with that AWP initially, watching for some kind of aggression towards A main, and this is just Envy being spread out, just making sure they don't get caught off guard by anything that FaZe is going to open this round up with. Very default, essentially, from both teams. Rain is just kind of rotating between the A bomb site and middle. Jacob's going to be there all alone. He's isolated. Fox with the AWP has pushed out towards the B bomb site, so he's got intel, and that's a nice recovery. A good flick over to MBK. Didn't have the shot initially, but transfers very, very well. Finds an opening kill. Also finds a lot of intel, and that denies map control towards the B side of the map for Envy.
It was looking really sketchy for Fox for a couple of seconds there as he started to move his way out into the open. You were curious if he was just going to get his head ripped off his shoulders, but as he said, did manage to recover from that position. Meanwhile, Jacob is going to get picked off from the other AWP on the battlefield. That's in the hands of Kenny S. And a further trade in mid means that Envious can now start to snake their way up here. This affords them two more avenues to aggress on through highway and also, of course, on vents, and they're going to make the most of this one.
Got 35 seconds to figure out where they want to go. The defense is pretty split, but Fox pushed up towards B still. That's the big play, because he could actually ruin Envy if they try and go back towards that B bomb site, and they might lean away from that just because they know Fox pushed there earlier, got their pick. They haven't had any presence over towards that B site, so without that control, they are going to transfer over towards the A site, where it's just AZ. Kyo's actually leaning more towards the B bomb site, so this is a very, very susceptible site for the taking.
It's all on AZ, and he gets picked off from Kenny S as he tries to have a quick look towards A main. 10 seconds on the timer, and you've got even one frag from that position that could have been all but done for Envious, but instead, FaZe just back on off, looking to recover these weapons and retrieve them for the next round. Or are they? They're actually going back in again. So they're hungry for this one. I thought originally they were just going to back away and cut their losses, but they're actually going straight in for this one. And it is doable when you consider that there isn't really any utility other than HE in the hands of Envious. If Kiyoshima can get himself in close on A main, then it's doable, but his partner in crime has fallen. Meanwhile, the spray control is on point from Kiyoshima, but Happy is there to dispatch him. And Envy has finally get themselves on the board.
Yeah, nice mid-round call from Envy. Knowing very much they had no control over towards that other half of the map and head up towards the A site and split it. We saw from Lounge Gaming earlier, they were in these kind of mid-round situations, 3-on-3s, they were very much gambling towards one site, just playing together and just saying, all right, you come B or we probably lose the round. FaZe goes the other route. They just split up. They have one player everywhere, one player mid, one player A, one player B, and they didn't get a good read on the situation. And AZ couldn't do anything to hold them off and buy time for the rotation. So, good round from Envy. First is on the board. And look at this buy out of FaZe. They're down to two Famases. They're almost out of utility already. A minute and a half left in the round. One smoke left on Rain. That's going to be towards middle. And Kenny's got plenty of time and plenty of openings for his AWP to find a pick.
And this, in a nutshell, is why I thought they may try and just save those two weapons from the last round so they could have more utility here in round five. But maybe they can still make it work for themselves. We saw Fox get the opening pick in the last round. They weren't able to capitalize on that one as mid very quickly got lost afterwards. Jake coming in an identical position this time, and Kenny S may very well sense this out. Meanwhile, the rest of his team starting to filter their way through mid. Jacob has so many avenues to cover, but he has gone big now. We're getting a frag for his team back out over. As Rain fell down first, second kill for Jacob, but he will be silenced afterwards. And again, almost a carbon copy of the last round, other than this time, it looks like B is going to be the site of choice for Envious.
Yeah, not working out initially. AZ finds that kill. Happy and NBK, 45 seconds left. They don't have to commit to this. They have a chance to rotate back, but they're going to go for it. Smoke down towards CT spawn. Fox misses that initial shot. Not going to miss the second one. Happy falls. A one-on-three situation. MBK is able to take out the AWP, but they salvage it. AZ picks that up. Two kills for him. Two kills for Jacob. And FaZe responds immediately, and this might force a save situation. And it is. I mean, no one can really buy any rifles and have any kind of strong buy on the Envy side. So they're back onto a save. The CT side has a chance here to go up 5-1. Build up some bank behind this as well. See the MP9 come out on Rain trying to get that bonus money.
Position is he going to elect to play for himself with the MP9? It's looking as though he's heading towards the A site, but it's going to be an all-out B push right now with those upgraded pistols. Here comes Kiyoshima from the side. Two frags for him. It's an absolute slaughter. From Envious's perspective, just Apex has chimed back with one kill, but the bomb is dropped in a precarious position that leaves Apex with the AWP, and he will fall down as well. Envious 5-1 behind, but still plenty of time to play with. But you can see, because they did go for those upgraded pistols, their economy still not fantastic.
Yeah, not. I mean, that's what's crazy. It's just that minimal investment of those $300 P250s, flashbang a CZ, and they have to double save essentially. So they do get four deagles to work with. Devil's got armor and a P250 and one flashbang, but all the reliance on these deagles to find one of those headshots early on to provide an opening in the defense. They're going to have to lean on them very, very much. Although when you have four, you can at least use them a little bit like a scout, where if one player gets a tag, another player could clean them up. But still, it's going to be tough times at Fox, remaining aggressive with this AWP. This could be a huge opportunity for Envy.
It really could. This could backfire horribly for FaZe, and it looking like it could do, but they did have the two-man death squad. AZ was there to pick up the pieces, and of course the AWP as well, if he so chooses. More players starting to funnel their way over towards Squeaky Door, where the bomb is dropped.
That's so smart. If you're going to get that aggressive, have two members there, AZ's able to back up Fox, even though he falls, to protect the AWP, so you don't actually give a gun over to a save. And actually, that might be a situation where they probably... Okay, so if they know that that's going to be a deagle save, if they don't push like that. I highly doubt it. They had to have thought that was a buy and try and take control, try and make some kind of aggressive stance.
Yeah, I think they're kind of caught out. I was kind of surprised as well. We saw the double eco coming in from Envious after those pistol upgrades, but it is up to Rain to finished the round off convincingly for FaZe. Here comes the buy finally, and it's going to be a really solid buy because of those double ecos, but still, that has put Envious at a huge disadvantage already at 6-1, and we mentioned before that the meta of cash is starting to shift more towards the T side, so this is a pretty brutal start from Envious's perspective.
Yeah, it really is. This is tough. And it was curious as well, because FaZe won the knife round, and they picked to start on the CT side, despite knowing that it's been T-sided lately. An aggression towards the B-bomb site.
Here we go, Rain's going to come out with the M4. Oh my goodness, MBK actually gets the frag. He's going to get traded out, but Terrace won't be too bothered about that one. 1-4 on trade now funnels FaZe into a more sporadic defense. They're looking to bounce back with a potential boost into vents, I think that is, from Fox and Jacob. Yeah, it's going to be Jacob who gets boosted up. Meanwhile, Envious decide to go over to the A side, which is pretty much being abandoned, apart from the two players in Highway, who are now going to start to throw in some incendiaries. There's Kiyoshima, Apex answers back just beforehand. Nade is going to do quite a bit of damage onto the site. Devil down to 22. Bomb planted, but still plenty of utility for FaZe. Molly's being exchanged between the two teams. Here comes the flashbang. Kenny S gets wrecked by that one, and a second one as well. Glass Cannon up, so he's not going to be able to take too much damage, but two huge frags for Kenny, and he gets a third as well! Huge from Kenny S, what a beast!
That is a sick play from Kenny, and that's the crucial spot you want to hold when you're defending against a retake. That forklift is so important to have as a terrorist. But those shots, Kenny comes alive here. Those flashbangs, not good. That was a sick flick in its own. Good recovery there, and then obviously the no-scope. Vintage Kenny there. Hopefully, I mean, he's going to need. They're down 2-6. They can't get reset here. Thankfully, they've broken the economy of FaZe. It is a buy up. There are CZs and armor and an AWP on Fox. But they're going to need more of that out of Kenny moving forward into this match.
Yeah, it wouldn't be Kenny S without no scope.
Yeah, exactly.
He has to reach that quota per huge play. And he certainly did with abundance there. Fox, the only weapon into this round worth noting. Although the CZs, to be fair, are absolutely brutal at close range, as we saw yesterday on Cobblestone. But Envious, again, very similar to Nip. They realize the situation, they're not going to play themselves into any danger, just waiting.
And actually, this is where the CZs can really be dangerous. If you walk them right into a stack, so many crossfires they could be at. So mid-control for Envy again. No one from FaZe is here. But there is a push out of Squeaky Door. Rain's going to lead the way, and actually that catches one player off guard. That's Apex, and NVK's been found out by Fox. This all of a sudden is very, very dangerous.
What is happening here, Envious? They've now gift wrapped a weapon away, and Happy gets wrecked off the drive by 5-7. That should never be happening. And a round that you feel FaZe had no chance to win. They've picked up, and not just that, they didn't lose a single player in the process.
Yeah, that's horrendous for Envy to lose that round. Full mid control as well, on top of everything.
Here's a timeout.
And that might be needed after a round like that. That's
a tilt timeout, maybe.
Yeah. That's what you say, all right. Well, we need to figure something out, because that was really bad. I know Yankro's probably over in the green room right now, just tilted after watching that one, but to lose that, and that's the thing, that resets the losing bonus as well, and now they're going to be back onto a save. Apex is down at 1,400. This might be around that Envy decides, okay, we need to force buy here, but they wouldn't have much if they go for that. I don't think they'd be able to have a single rifle unless they drop one over or go for Galil's.
The thing is, if they do force in, and even if they do knock down FaZe, it's risk versus reward, right? Because they've got three players on 4K we're going to have towards 5K after this round. They can easily rebuy again.
Yeah.
So it's a huge risk for Envious. It's not a huge payoff.
Because you essentially have to win two rounds in a row since they won it.
Exactly, yeah. And if you just force buy and straight up lose here, you're looking at a 9-2, potentially 10-2 deficit, and then you're up the creek without a paddle.
And that is just so crippling for Envy. That's one of those rounds that just throws this whole half into a different timeline. Really, really tough for Envy after that one. And very spread out as well. Those first two kills that came out, no traits for Envy. It's like they had no one there backing up whichever players were taken out. MBK gets picked off by an AWP, so a little bit hard on that spot, but that's really, really tough to recover from, and that's why you see this pause, obviously.
As I say, like the tilt timeout, really, just to try and steady yourselves again, just to try and mull over where you've been coming down wrong. I've got to say, though, FaZe have came out the blocks incredibly confidently in this game. They've been landing pretty much all the shots. There's been a couple of whiffed opportunities from both teams, but FaZe have been by far the better team, and you can see it obviously by the score, but sometimes you get into this kind of score and a team is narrowly missed out on a couple of rounds. This has been pretty one-sided so far.
Yeah, this is one of those maps that FaZe was very, very good at when they were strong towards the end of last year. It's a map they beat Virtus Pro on a couple times. Most memorable was the 16-0. I mean, this almost seems like it's kind of like riding a bike. They've gotten into the flow of it a little bit. Unlike Train yesterday when they played Virtus Pro on it, where it was almost like, all right, guys, that might be a little bit too aggressive of a map pick versus Virtus Pro. Here on Cash, They seem to be getting in the swing of things pretty well.
Now, I was curious how Kiyoshima would be performing against his ex-team, 9-for-2, joint top fragging. Nicely done.
Kiyo was right. Either way, triple push now for FaZe towards the B-bomb, so they're actually just going to boost one up in vents instead of pushing forward. NBK's watching for any kind of aggression. Happy over towards door. Everyone on Envy, they're just set up in a default, seeing if they can find any kind of intel, punish any kind of aggressive play. They didn't buy, so they only have the pistols. Two flashbangs to work with. And you got to imagine, with no smokes, and no real arsenal with which to work with, it would just be head back towards the B-bomb site, throw your flashes, hope it catches Kiyo or Jacob off guard, and see what comes from this push.
Again, it's rolling the dice here, really. You're hoping more from a mistake of FaZe than a monumental play from Envious. This would be a Herculean throw if FaZe lose this round from this point. Especially as Envious is starting to congregate around the B side of the map, starting to push in slowly. As you mentioned, two flashbangs to work with. Pretty solid positions from FaZe. Jacob again up in vents. Kiyoshima behind him, watching checkered. That smoke is going to stop the initial charge from Envious, but they are going to actually go through this one. And right into the embracing arms of Jacob. And even if they pick up Jacob, they've got Kiyoshima to deal with, and he's going to get the spray in effect onto Kenny S. He has to be very careful here as Apex actually charges through onto CT side, does pick up the AWP for himself, so it's going to make this round a little bit more interesting. Meanwhile, Devil's gone in with his P250, only 2 HP to play with, and Kiyoshima runs out of bullets. That's going to cost him his life. Apex, 20 seconds to play with, but he doesn't have the bomb. He's going to have to traverse out into no man's land, and in doing so, could very well find himself a corpse, and there we go. Rain just drops down, picks himself up the kill. Envious, 8-2 behind.
Yeah, almost, but Kiyo is the insurance policy there, just behind that box, able to just delay, get a couple kills, buy time for the rotation to come, and even when that AWP gets salvaged, it's just, there's too much damage dealt already. So 8-2, this is the real round. Apex is going to be stuck onto that Tech 9. He was the lowest in terms of money. All AKs outside of that. They have three Molotovs to work with, actually. Plenty of smokes. But they haven't done anything super aggressive. They're opening up in these default stances, just waiting for any kind of intel, seeing what they can find. No real giveaway at the beginning of these rounds, and it's going to be FaZe who opens things up with the aggression, the reverse boost. Apex is spotting this from far back. He's only got the Tech 9, so he can't really punish it, but he'll at least know it's there.
Yeah, now here come Envious out the woodwork. Kenny S is the man to put Jacob down. Remember, this is the round that the tactical timeout was called for, to detilt and also to try and wrap their heads around what they can do differently. So it would be a body blow if they just go in and end up losing this one as well in similar fashion. That first kill is definitely going to alleviate some of the pressure, however. And if they do push on to B, it's going to be only AZ to stop them. Move back into quad. There are still Molotovs and smokes aplenty for Envious to use as they look to set play onto the site. And Rain is actually still on highway, so here comes the push. AZ's been dinked as the drive-by comes in. It's Apex that gets the frag, and Envious are looking to run away with round 11. There's nothing that FaZe could have done about that one. AZ got insta-dinked as soon as he peeked.
Yeah, it's a safe call already from Fox and Kiyo. They're just making sure no one's going to be flanking from behind him at the B site. That's a good shot from Fox. That death of Jacob, though, boosted up. He stuck around just a little bit too long. Once he's spotted out from so far away, he's got to know that there's going to be a second player peeking from below him. He should have fallen back there, not getting picked off. But either way, FaZe had a lean towards that B bomb site in the mid-round, feeling that maybe that was going to be the end game, and Envy just tricks him out, goes over towards the A site. Pretty easy entries there, especially once AZ gets dinked.
These two weapons, if they get saved, would afford FaZe another buy into the next round. So it's pretty crucial they keep this AWP and M4 in their hands. Fox is going to put them one step closer to just that. And with no terrorists anywhere near, and Envious' economy not fantastic as well, they may think about just holding off the charge. There you go. Because those two saved weapons, it's an easy rebuy for FaZe. Game back on again for Envious.
And this is the big one. This is where they can't get reset here. They haven't been able to string two rounds together in essentially this entire half. They've yet to do it, so they need to move forward. At least they have some money built up from a stronger win. But again, they have FaZe on such low economy. If they can win this one, break the money, and then just win the anti-eco, that's all they have to do, and they can catch up in the scoreline pretty quickly. So Envy's not out of it just yet, but this is another very important round for them. And Fox, he's going to get aggressive one more time. He's had success doing this. That pop flash is going to force him back, but he's going to go for the re-peek. He's going to lose that battle this time to MBK. So Fox down early, and that's the AWP taken out of the hands of FaZe.
Yeah, and you could see that MBK was going for that pre-fire consistently. He was expecting that charge to come through from Fox, who walked straight into it head first. So very nicely done from Envious. And again, Fox, who has been one of the players to get a lot of those impact frags on 11 for 7 currently. That's a big scalp to claim. What do they do with this, though? We've seen Envious get the opening pick a few times and do absolutely nothing with it.
Yeah, and they're still doing absolutely nothing. Still spread out into a default right now. Haven't really committed anywhere whatsoever, looking to see if there's going to be any kind of a reaggression from the FaZe side, but it's a split defense. Rain and AZ in the A-bomb site, Jacob and Keo in the B-bomb site, no one guarding mid whatsoever, so Envy, they could just choose to take this. Kenny's boosted up, waiting for the small top to expire, and there it is. There's the taken mid. It's just, where do you go from here? Do you prod up towards the A-bomb site, see what you can find? You know you've taken the AWP away from him. But with NBK still over towards the B bomb site, it looks like this is going to turn into a mid to B split. Happy's more than likely just going to stay at the highway box and lurk it out, try and pick off some rotations, try and slow it down as much as possible. And actually, they've converted back. They do apply a little bit of pressure over towards B that's pulled Rain off the A site. And AZ, again, is isolated. Rain's got to get back to help him out.
The problem here as well is because there's only about 15 seconds left on the timer, if a couple of frags come in from FaZe, that completely stops the charge. There was an incendiary thrown, was extinguished from the smoke. Can see that Apex, Devil, and MBK all pretty close to death. 5 seconds to go. Bomb is going to get planted. Meanwhile, Happy lurking in connector. Bests Kiyoshima. And that pretty much is the round lost. FaZe tap out, try and save these two M4s.
Yeah, a lot of very low players on the Envy side, but FaZe just has no options to clean them out. So that's a good round from Envy. Get that opening pick. You slow things down. You make the defense feel a little bit of pressure. Rain is pulled away just by the most minimal flashbangs thrown over towards B and Happy and Apex. They're going to take out all the guns. Now, I talked about the low economy situation that FaZe was in. This is going to force a save. There's no M4s even able to be brought out whatsoever. Even if they went for Famas's, they'd have very light armor or utility. But Envy, I mean, they just have to survive this one. Because you got to imagine, if they had lost that eco a couple rounds back, or 4 rounds ago, they'd be sitting in a pretty nice position instead. I mean, that reversed everything. That Envy could have actually ended up with a really strong T-half, but that's reversed everything.
That's a really good point. It would have changed the entire dynamic of how this half has gone thus far if they didn't lose that, which is why it was such a heartbreaking round. It seems they have steadied somewhat. First kill going their way is always going to make things a little bit happier. MBK just watching, waiting for this charge to come in, and indeed it will. You fancy himself to get all these kills. Well, he's actually run out of bullets and will end up falling, but again, they have the two-man stack, and this time it's Devil who will put Fox down. Eviscerates him out the round. Kiyoshima also falls victim. There's the 1D from AZ. Can he get any more? He is going to pick up Happy as well, so he's taking plenty of money away from Envious, but with only 19 HP, he can't hope to clutch this round out.
No reason for him not to save this AK-47, though. Fox is low on 1,900. I don't even think he'll be able to have an AWP in the next round. So this AK-47 is actually very, very crucial if they want to have some extra utility, an extra player with just a better arsenal. So this AK-47 has big implications if he's able to get away with it.
Absolutely, and he seems to be feeling the same way. So he's going to just go back to T-spawn, potentially watch for an exit frag or two. The economy of Envious is starting to boom somewhat, but that is going to hurt them a little bit, sting a little bit with those weapons lost from AZ's Deagle work. That looks like he will be able to save this one, just going to hide behind the box. So, Envious, pick up yet another round. That will be 3 in a row.
And they've been able to build up good money behind this. A couple players before these buys come out, over $8,000. That's huge. That'll allow them to sustain some losses through the end of this half. There's only 2 rounds left, so Envy is sitting in a situation where no matter what happens, they're going to have solid buys for the next 2 rounds.
Certainly. Well, let's see how Envy are going to approach this round. Typically, it has been a little bit more slower pace than you probably expect, but there's been a lot of explosions as the last 25 seconds comes to fruition. I think that Apex has ate a bit of damage there on the early part of this round due to a grenade, I believe it was, that was fired on in to mid.
This defaults change up a little bit. AZ takes a good amount of damage, but that's from Kenny spamming, I believe. So he hits him through the wall, but there is more aggressive lean towards this A bomb site. Devil and NBK are watching B and mid. Kenny was far deeper into A main, and with that kind of pressure, Happy all the way up towards door, they just fall away from all of it now.
Yep.
Fox still has that AWP, but he's not peeking deep into the B bomb site.
Thing as well, with AZ being knocked down to 41, that almost forces someone to stay in highway, because they realize one HE that just falls on out, he dies. That leaves A very vulnerable indeed, so you have to be caught in two minds. Jacob's going to go down finally. He did take a player with him, however. Kenny S is there to rectify the issue. FaZe with the aforementioned Daisy, whose low has just been picked off. This is a really poor round for them. It's looking good for Envious again. This will be four in a row. Fox is going to play aggressively, misses the shot, and that was his one chance to get anything done from this round. That's on Kiyoshima, who's going to go ahead and try and peek as well. And he could fall prey to the exact same fate.
Yeah, he's got nowhere to go here. There's no way he saves this M4, so this is going to be a good round from Envy. He does get MVK, but there's one behind him, one following MVK up. That pop flash is going to be a little bit too far, although the shot is missed, and he actually somehow, just the timing of it, gets away from Happy, who's coming in behind. Now he swings around to take this fight, not going to win it. So six rounds for Envy now, and again, it's going to be a very low economy for FaZe, so a very weak buy in the last round of this half. Envy's brought this very, very close. After a dodgy start to this game, not being able to string two rounds together, now they've got four in a row. This has actually turned out pretty big for Envy.
Yeah, we saw the resilience of Envious yesterday, and they ended up losing against Tempo Storm, but what was it, like a 13-2, 12-3 half, I think? They brought it back to very nearly overtime. So it goes to show that these guys are down but never out. And an 8-7 half wouldn't be too bad. In actual fact, it'd be fantastic, considering how this map started for them. Really poor buy up from FaZe. Have to just pretty much go all in as it is the last round of the half. Rain though with a CZ is going to make that work, and look at the aggression as well from the Mag 7. Jacob is on the prowl. Devil could run out of bullets, and he's run out of life as his head is dispatched from his body. Devil will fall down, and that is going to be the weapon traded out. That being said, though, Envious is going to bounce back in the best possible way with a kill onto B site. Now the bomb needs to be planted at the back of the site, I believe that is. Kiyoshima, meanwhile, again from the back of checkered box, is going to do work. Here comes AZ. This retake is doable, but it's Kenny S. We know he's capable of pulling off these clutches. We've seen it before so many times. There's the first one. He's going to be lining up the second, but AZ through the box, lands the headshot, and FaZe will take the three-round lead going into halftime.
You could almost see that round working out for Kenny, but again, it's the other player. It's Kyo, the former Envy player, who makes a huge play, just staying behind that checkers box. Again, it's not cleared by Envy, and he bides his time. That one kill he had on the player in checkers, it's only one kill, but it's the most important because that opens up the entire path for that retake. The two members drop out of vents, it's clear so they can't get punished for that, and then they can just easily retake the site in a 3-on-2. The two remaining Envy players are pinned into that site. So a 9-6 half from FaZe. Good recovery for Envy in that half, but it started out so dodgy, and that's why you don't see him at a higher scoreline.
And again, you just wonder, you ponder back to that round that they ended up losing, when FaZe run almost to full-on eco. If they win that, could be a completely different set of circumstances. It could be 9-6 to them, to be fair.
Yeah, it might have very well been just a two-round swing for FaZe once they win that. So that might be something that Envy has to look back and shake their heads at and feel that they punished themselves. But they can't think about it now. Now they got to switch over to the CT side, which has been tougher. We've seen recently all throughout Cash, dating back towards right before the Major, it's been all T sides on this. But a good defense from FaZe, so that bodes well for him at least.
Certainly does, but at least Envious have a fighting chance. It was looking like they were just going to be edged out of this map before it even really got started. They win this pistol, they're right back in it. Let's see what they're going to be buying right off the bat. Apex with the smoke and the defuse, everyone else with the Kevlar is pretty standard. Whereas FaZe have a little bit of utility to use as well. Looking like they could be faking this one as well. They've just rained over on the B side of the map. The rest of this team looking to set up onto A.
Rain's just over there to look for any kind of aggression because, like I mentioned, that this default A CT pistol on a cache, retake towards the A bomb site, stack towards B. Every once in a while, teams decide instead of just playing passively at B, they'll just push up and try to get a quick flank. That's all that Rain is watching out for at the moment. Actually, everyone from FaZe is just being very passive, just watching each of their positions for any aggression.
Now Rain starts to push on in. Maybe a multi-layered purpose here from him. And to be fair to Envious, they're actually waiting for this themselves. They're not giving anything up. Both teams, like statues at this point, looking to try and peer around, see if they can get that one tap, quickly switch this round in their favor. Again, Envious are setting up for the retake, so it's really on FaZe now to start to push out onto the A site and see what they can get done. The smokes are starting to land, and here comes the charge right behind it. Meanwhile, there is some confrontation in mid, but it is Apex that's the man that could get this done. He's going to have to set up the rest of his team for this retake, and the fact that NBK has gone down is going to make that so much more difficult. Rain's coming around from the back as well, so it's almost a double flank. The hunters are about to become the hunted. As Fox is there, he gets picked off, but now it's all on Rain. Lands the headshot, finishes Devil off with a body shot afterwards. But he gets taken out from Kenny S. These frags just exchanging back and forth. AZ comes in, he's going to end up getting picked off as well, and that's all on Jacob. He's running out of bullets, but he is somehow still healthy on HP. The bomb is being defused, meanwhile. And it's going to be on Kenny. He has to try and pick off the head. He does, but it was so close. Somehow, Envious pick it up, though, and they're right back in this match.
Yeah, and you could see Jacob a little bit upset, asking for the HP, but even if he gets that kill, the kit on Happy, I mean, this is a little bit different. We saw Apex was the one watching for that rotation into watching for that A hit to come out. He was the one playing retake initially at the A truck, and he had the smoke and the kit. Every once in a while, you see that on one of the B players because there's more people around him. Doesn't dictate where that rotation has to come from, but the kit was picked up by Happy anyways. Now, no investment into the second round in terms of armor. They do upgrade some Deagles, some P250s, so trying to do some damage to the CT economy, but it's all rifles for the Envy side.
Yep, very heavy investment from Envious, so can't afford to lose too many weapons out of this one, but that's a great way to start things off. Happy and Kenny S, both with kills, and, well, it looks like FaZe were about to just crumble away under the pressure of Envious. P2000 pulled out the sidearm, not enough to pick up the kill in the first time of asking, and there's Happy. Envious, flawless round.
Yeah, huge, that they don't lose anyone. So now they're going to have all these rifles, they're going to have the nades, and with the plant in the first round, FaZe is going to buy up the AK-47s. Because of the Deagle investment, they're a little bit light on utility, or actually very light on utility. Only 3 flashbangs, 2 smokes to work with into the round. But FaZe, you're going to go for this win, and it's all rifles. Normally, we see some SMGs at this point, but both of these teams, knowing it was going to come down to this third round buy, just go straight for the M4s, the Famases, and FaZe going heavy towards the A bomb site. Fox towards door, Jacob and AZ, and Keo now towards A main. It's going to be a reverse boost from Envy, though. This could turn into a quick flank.
Certainly could, especially as, other than Rain, who's in garage, no one's actually watching for this one, so Happy is going to be able to get around the back of them. Spray out, and the bomb has been dropped in A main. That is horrendous from FaZe's perspective. And Rain, the man who was in garage, has now got himself into mid, does get dinked for his troubles, finished off from Kenny S. This has been a pretty confident start from Envious in the second half thus far.
Yeah, MVK aggressive, gets us opening 2 kills and pretty much takes all the teeth out of that attack. Just opens things up, Envy can go absolutely nowhere from there. And that's really, really tough for FaZe to deal with. Not enough progress made with those 5 AKs with that early buy. So they're back on to save. Only 1 Deagle bought up. Excuse me, 2 Deagles bought up. But this is going to be a tough situation because now Envy has the advantage of their economy. They only lose 2 players there, so they have actually built up Kenny and Happy of about $6,000 each.
Mm-hmm.
Devil's got $5,000, so there's a lot of money on this Envy side now, on the CT side built up. They're going to have plenty of Molotovs, nades for the next couple of rounds. They could stop FaZe once again, and then it would be back onto a save for them.
Another reason that was so brutal for FaZe to not get any weapons away from Envious in a full-on AK round. You're expecting fireworks and headshots to be traded between the two teams, but it was completely one-sided in Envious's favor. So as you say, if they do lose a couple of these weapons, you'll expect to see some AWPs picked up instead, and Envious just to be that much stronger afterwards. So a B play looks on the cards for FaZe. Gonna have to run through this smoke though that Devil has just thrown out. Already turning his back, expecting the flash to come in. Isn't forthcoming. Instead, he's gonna relocate, put his feet firmly on the ground and get a double and make that a triple actually frag. Huge for him, huge for Envious, but you're expecting that really.
Not that it might necessarily change too much in terms of them winning the round, but if you're going to invest in Deagles and P250s, invest in some smoke, invest in some flashes, and give yourself a chance at least getting the bomb down. At least, you know, maybe you get 1 or 2 kills, you take some rifles away, force some rebuys, and get the bomb planted. That can be a huge swing, and it provides opportunities in the future for you. If you're just going to buy these pistols and go for duels against, you know, AKs and M4s, it's going to turn into a slaughter like that more often than not. So Envy finally take the lead here. And again, aggression. Happy's going to boost Apex, or reverse that. Happy's going to get boosted up. Also a push towards the B bomb site to try and do some kind of coordinated aggression. Kenny gets the trade. There's Apex falls, but Happy's still up top. He's going to get one. He can get a second as well. He transfers over, and he does find it. That's Jacob down.
And more brutal. That's the bomb also dropped. He comes down for Kiyoshima, who is there waiting for him, looking for the second. Trying to transfer onto Highway. Bit of a flirtatious confrontation ends in Kenny S picking off AZ, and that puts all the pressure on Kiyoshima. He'd love to get this clutch. 1:10 to play with. The bomb is down right next to Kenny S. So it's not a case of him being able to play the mind games here. It's just a case of locking it down from Envious's perspective.
Well, Keo knows he's got to get a little bit tricky. That's why he's not going directly at the bomb. He knows Kenny's got that AWP. So he's got to try and just get a little bit lucky with the timing of Kenny not looking that way. And initially, it's going to work out. I think he spotted him there.
Moving in slowly. 45 seconds left on the timer. Kenny S. Oh, his gun barrel has just given him away there. Kiyoshima's playing it smart. Gonna come around, boom. The execute in effect, gonna get the bomb as well, 35 seconds. The problem now is he has absolutely no idea where MBK could be, and he's watching from the back, but MBK misses his chance. Now Kiyoshima will get the plant. Comes down, potentially, to the next shot. If Kiyoshima lands it in the head, it's all over for Envious in this round. He's gone into check and lands the shot. The clutch is real. Kiyoshima, 1v2s his previous team.
And that's just gotta be a dagger that it was Kyo who does it. That smoke provides him two cover. Cover to get into the bomb site and then to relocate over towards Checker when MBK is trying to push through. MBK had no idea he was in that position. And with low HP, that's such a sick play from Kyo. What a beautiful 1-on-2 to win. 4 kills in the round total. So a huge round for him, but you can just see here, MBK had no idea that was coming.
Did not expect that Checkered push at all. That being said, 10-10. Envious. If you have just joined us, they were getting wrecked on the first half. It looked like they were just going to be edged out now. And they have the potential to take the lead for what I believe would be the first time in this entire matchup.
There's no utility on Rain and Fox right now, and Jacob's only at one flashbang, so this has got to be a very, very frugal round for FaZe. They're going to have to win some duels. They don't have a lot of options because that came down to that 1-on-2 because they lost so many members, and this is that reset round where Envy, if they win this, no more money for FaZe in the next one. This is a big round for FaZe in terms of what they can do moving forward because Envy's economy is not that strong either. So this has big implications on how the second half of this match is going to play out. And right now, I mean, both of these teams on their T sides opening up into just a lot of defaults. And it was talked about on the desk. Both of these guys, I mean, the in-game leader for FaZe missing their coach. It's back on to Rain. Envy as well. They don't have Maniac here. You know, their calling is not the most tactical in the world. So everyone just kind of spreading out in these defaults to open rounds up. Just to prevent themselves from making some kind of mistake.
One of the reasons we expected this to be such a interesting matchup with plenty of huge individual performances, as they may just default back onto that as well, just expecting players to charge on in, get the entry frags. This time around, it's going to be Apex who holds off the mid-push. MBK's nade does significant damage to Rain. Jacob got tickled by it as well, and I was able to hold the position. Oh my goodness, I thought he was going to get that onto MBK. That could be a huge turn of events in favor of FaZe, and they now manage to get themselves onto the site and get the bomb planted. Devil is going to be taking point for his team up on the toxic barrels. Here we go. Player in A main, one quad, one still on site. Pretty decent positions from FaZe. No utility apart from a couple flashes to draw them out either, so Envious are going to have to go right in for this one. The first two kills go in their way. Jacob gets picked off through the smoke. And Envious, for the first time, are going to be in the lead here.
Devil, such an important player on that retake. He's the one who grabs control of Forklift. There's no one there for FaZe, so he's got a great angle over towards quad, applies the pressure, and that defense on the retake just kind of collapses underneath it. This is that terrible situation I was talking about for FaZe. They do get the plant, so they get some bonus money, but reset, they're going to have to go back onto the pistols. Might not even invest into armor because they don't have a losing bonus build up, so they can't really afford the armor. They have another buy in the next round that'll be pretty solid, but Envy here with a good chance to build up more money because it's been essentially depleted, so they need to be able to sustain some of those losses. And Kenny's back on the AWP, that's the biggest thing. Also, 4 Molotovs still left on the Envy side, and it's going to be a heavy play towards the A bomb site for FaZe. At the moment, there's a stack in the A bomb site, Happy up on top of NBK.
It's going to be a rough one to try and hold off, but Rain gets right up into the face of NBK, who's wondering where Stilts just went as his teammate was picked off. Now on Kiyoshima, he just charges through with a Tech 9, so this could be a bomb plant. He actually decides to hold his ground for now. Realizing that Molotov was imminent, decides to move himself back, lands the headshot. Surely not again, Envious. Surely not again, Kiyoshima! With a second huge clutch, keeping FaZe in this game.
Just Kyo, just with the daggers, these 1-on-2s that he's winning. That one's so unlikely, no armor. What a sick shot. That one right there is impressive. Here, Devil is a little bit too far out of cover.
Oh my god.
Makes it a little bit easier, but what an impressive performance from Kyo so far coming into this revenge matchup, essentially.
Did he get so carried away that he forgot to buy armor, or is that a bug?
Looks like he didn't buy armor, but either way, Fox is going to get the opening kill. That could be a detriment, but yeah, maybe just a little bit too happy. Speaking of which, Jacob gets that opening, or he defaults to Happy on that reverse boost. There's been a lot of those lately in this matchup from Envy. And actually, Kenny's got good perch, and this is turning around now.
That's where the issue comes in. He didn't have armor, so he got instantly aim punched from the pistol. And he had $6,000 at the start of this round, so that's actually a pretty big deal.
And maybe losing a little bit of composure after a second 1-on-2, but if you look at Kenny, biding his time, but he was spotted out. Someone must have seen him on radar. AZ comes back to punish him for not taking that shot sooner. Now AZ's going to get a second as well. Looks so good for Envy. It's starting to collapse. Apex, here's the next one up. He finds a headshot. Can he get a second one? Rain's brought down very low. AK-47 for Apex, and he's just going to keep pushing forward. He's going to keep up the aggression.
Still a lot of time to play with, though, for FaZe. Nice shot from Fox. That does put them back into firm footing. MBK only has a P250. And the bomb now over towards A site will be planted. MBK still hoping for this B play. It's not going to happen.
This is now two rounds that Envy has dropped the ball on their anti-ecos in this match. And the both of them are causing huge issues for how they could win this match.
Bomb planted. I just want to give you a hug because you're really struggling with this cold. I can hear it.
It's happening.
It's all good. Anyway, NBK has picked himself up an AK-47. I think that's pretty much where this round ends. Or will it, actually? Does he really fancy this?
Why not go for it?
How is he moving? The size of his balls must be weighing him down too much. Just hear concrete scraping underneath him.
Well, he's not dedicated to it too much. He couldn't find that kill quick enough to make it make sense for him to go for it, especially with no kit. Bomb timer's running low. So he is going to fall away from this with the AK-47. At least he brings that into the next round.
Indeed he will. That gives him a better buy-up, but it's been so back and forth like a pendulum in these last few rounds. Just when you think that Envious are going to start to take that momentum. You get a sick clutch from Kiyoshima again, who really has been the MVP, I think it's safe to say, for his team. Not only is he on 20 for 13, but he's got huge impact kills. He's got two clutches.
He's got to be loving this. He's got to be absolutely loving this. Very important performance in a huge matchup.
Mm-hmm.
And now they have the advantage of the AWP as well. Fox has that. There's nothing of the sort on the Envy side. Kenny's already out of utility. Speaking of the AWP for Envy, they do boost Devil up in events. And this time it looks like there's going to be a little bit more aggression earlier on for FaZe. Jacob's going to get boosted up. Rain's already out of mid smokes. And there's an opening pick on Apex. That's a nice shot. Devil was smoked out in events. And here's the aggressive peek from NBK. He gets it right back.
He sure will. A good trade. That was so awkward from Devil's perspective, though. Double mollies landed in vent. He extinguished one molly, but then ran into the next one. Lost a huge chunk of his HP. He's down to 28 now. Kenny S just wasn't expecting that. You can see he was peering towards highway, trying to watch out for his teammates' backs. Meanwhile, MBK, they very nearly lined up for him. Not quite today, though, for him. And now it's unhappy. On the site, all by his lonesome. Players all around him. There's the first kill. That was Rain, who was heavily tanked up just beforehand. He'd have been flashing off the wall, peeking after this one maybe. Nope, decides to relocate to the back of the site. He's going to put his feet on the ground again and get himself a kill, and that's a one-on-one. Fox has the AWP, though. If he misses that shot, he should get lights out. Happy comes back in and lands the spray, and Happy somehow takes that round out. I think Fox peered back round with the Tech 9 and missed everything.
Yeah, he had to have known. His teammate must have said that Happy was very, very low on HP. That pistol, though, not connecting with any bullets, and how these clutches are going back and forth for these teams. Huge play from Happy this whole time in the site. Nice timing on that peek with Rain, and you can see he's trying to see if he's getting wrapped upon, but he recovers just in time to find Jacob. But somehow, Fox can't land these shots on Happy. He survives with 12 HP, and back on the Tech 9. Some armor built up for FaZe, and this time all five of them heading towards the B bomb site. Kenny and Devil have a big job to do here.
Can Kiyoshima dig them out of a hole again? That's what they're hoping for. This time, though, he doesn't have an assault rifle to work with. The AK has been his guardian angel so far. Fox is the first to fall. Here comes the charge of the Tech 9s. The cavalry has gone on in. Apex is able to hold position for now. But now Rain has the AWP. Eyes trained into heaven. Bomb planted as well, so that's going to force a couple of these CTs out. However, the grenade comes on in. Rain has landed the shot. That's going to make this round interesting. Flashbang lands in his eyes. He can't see anything really, but goes back in. Apex, meanwhile, he's going to put down his teammate. So close, yet so far for FaZe, but at least they get the bomb planted, so a better buy-up into the next round.
Yeah, bomb plant was huge, but smart play from Apex. He gets that one kill as FaZe was entering into the bomb site. Gives Envy a man advantage for that retake. And then he just waits for his teammates. He doesn't get picked off. He doesn't die. Just throws some nades out. Plays it passive. So a good retake from Envy. FaZe almost getting away with one. A nice wrap onto the site. Kenny couldn't take enough kills with that AWP. But now this is the big buy from FaZe. With the losing bonus, with the $800 bonus from the plant, Fox able to have the AWP and plenty of utility behind it. In fact, all the FaZe members are really set on grenades right now.
This is a huge economic round for both teams, though, because Envious are in just as much jeopardy as FaZe are. if they lose this, they're looking at an eco themselves.
We said it was going to come down to this slugfest, right? And this is kind of what it's become at the end, where there's not a lot of money built up on each side. Each round is just so crucially important. Some of these clutches are having huge impact. The second half, I mean, despite the fact that FaZe has gotten, they've gotten three rounds, but it has looked like a mostly Envy half. If it wasn't for losing that eco, again, well, I mean, we just have to go back to that.
The thing is, two of their three rounds they've won were Kiyoshima ridiculous clutches.
Yes.
So on another day, you're looking at, what, like 9-1 on this half, something like that?
Kyo is just barely holding them in on this match. It's been such a crazy performance from him.
That being said, just a FAMAS in the hands of Devil. They've got kits, they've got plenty of grenades still to use. They've just shy of a minute to play with. Definitely feel the tension. This is an elimination match, and to think that FaZe or Envy are going to go home this early on is pretty nuts. And then we'll be feeling the pressure. Here comes the boost. It's going to be a double boost at that. Apex just going to be shoulder peeking with his Karen bit. Here comes the push through mid though.
Yeah, they have mid control, and actually this is very passive. Apex has just got to spot it out, and he's waiting to bide his time, but he gets picked off. He was supposed to just have the intel for when Devil was going to peek. There's one kill. Goes for a second. Does the damage, but AZ is lurking up highway. He's gotten inside the smoke. He's got a very advanced position. Pop flash peek from NVK. He gets two kills. That's huge.
It's so big, though, because they've not done that before. It's the first time we've seen that pop flash, and it completely wrecks FaZe. 12 seconds to play with a bomb is dropped outside of A main, and that is the round falling away now, surely. 6 seconds. All the CTs have to do is just hide and wait, and this will be their round. There we go, zero, and it's all over in round 26. Just trying to make sure they don't lose these weapons, and Kiyoshima will put down Devil. It's going to hurt them in this round. Their economy still isn't fantastic for Envious.
Pretty crazy, the bomb was all the way back there. That's a huge mistake. It almost feels like, I mean, they didn't even realize that it was all the way back there. So even if they have success taking this site, they might run out of time either way.
That was perfect timing, that pop flash as well.
Yeah, it was brutal. Nice play from NBK. That's the thing, that's kind of the important factor on this map. You lose map control somewhere, you have to regain it elsewhere. And they lose mid, so they just pop flash in A main. Something that NIP was doing a very good job at making sure that didn't happen. We saw Lounge Gaming get punished for that kind of a play many, many times in that matchup. But here, Envy's having plenty of success with it.
And speaking of Lounge Gaming, it's always interesting to see how CT sides approach the defense on cash. Lounge Gaming were very passive. They were very defensive as well. We never really saw the counter boost until the very end. Didn't really see the garage pushes. Didn't really see the squeaky door pushes. Envy's have done all of the above. And you can see that FaZe are consistently respecting that. They're not just sitting there and waiting and trying to set up the set plays. They're very cognizant of the fact that Envious could get right up in their faces through the smokes. Speaking of smokes, one just went over into mid. Kenny S picks up Fox, who went looking.
This is the thing with these default setups that are just coming out so often for FaZe, and even what Envy did, you know, Kenny's going to have a great chance to get an opening kill just like he did there, just because there's no set plan on how to take control of the map.
The Devil is trying to channel his inner Kiyoshima, who used this position time and time again. There's one. Can't quite get it done. It's actually a team kill from Jacob into the back of Kiyoshima. And that leaves Jacob all that remains. But not for long. Envious have three match points to keep themselves alive here in the DreamHack Masters.
And this might be their best opportunity to just take it, because the money is low. All that FaZe has, they don't get a plant there. All they have is a four-round losing bonus. Everyone hovering right around $3,000. They have one Galil on Kyo. He's only got a flash because he goes for that Galil. Same with Fox. I mean, they're stuck on one nade each, and Galil's the rest of the Rain, AZ, Jake, and they all have the Tech Nines. Which is interesting considering those are the three guys you'd pick out as like the big, the heavy fraggers, the stars of this team.
Absolutely would. And he goes to show how this game is battered and bruised, some of the ego, some of the confidence here from FaZe. Well, there's the counter boost, and Happy is going to make it work for himself. Looking for the second, he transfers, looking for a third, he gets it, and the bomb is out. Once again outside of A main, finally is picked off from Rain. There may be some questions from Apex, not to save Happy's life, but do they really care? Because Fox is in a 1v4, the stuff of nightmares.
Yeah, Happy just seals the deal in this matchup. Fox with essentially no chance into this one. Too much, it's plenty of time, but this is just too much to overcome, and there it is, Apex going to push up. He's going to clean it out, so Envy survived for a game. Despite the heroics of their former teammate, despite those huge clutches from Kyo, despite the issues of losing a couple anti-eco rounds throughout this match.
And despite being 8-2 behind in the first half.
Yeah, that's, and you mentioned it, the resilience. We saw it yesterday against Tempo Storm. Envy almost able to make that a comeback, but what a big match for them to win. So they survived and move on, and FaZe is going to have to end their DreamHack here.
Yeah, FaZe will be absolutely gutted not to win from that point. Being 8-2 ahead, you're looking good, you're feeling good, everything's going your way, and then suddenly Envious just wreck you.
Yeah, they did. They did kind of like flip a switch. Although it was, you know, the T-sides are what kind of worried me. And I know the panel talked about it with both teams, like in-game leaders missing a little bit. Just the amount of defaults we saw come out, like no real, like what we mentioned, like NIP had that set plan, that set tactical, that orchestra was beautiful. Didn't seem like Envy really had an idea of where they wanted to go, just setting up in those defaults, seeing what they found, and just kind of, you know, wheeling and dealing in the mid rounds. They had some success with it, but it does frighten me going forward against teams that are going to be a little bit more prepared.
I do worry a little bit, though, for Envious going forward. If they meet the likes of Luminosity or Astralis, are they going to be able to deal with that?
You know, there's no team who you shouldn't be fearful of meeting those teams. Those guys are playing really, really well right now.
But absolutely.
Congratulations to Envy.
Yeah, very much so. We're going to hear from one of them right now. Smix has an interview lined up right for us.
Thank you very much, Vince. First of all, congratulations, MVK. You not only stay in the tournament, but I feel like despite the fact that this was the elimination match, and of course those are always intense, this was intense on another level because felt like you were not only fighting for your tournament life, but for your pride as well.
Yeah, obviously. I think a lot of people were expecting that fight of Kyo against us. And yeah, it turned out to be very close. So yeah, I think it was a very intense match, and we're obviously very happy to win it.
So prior to the game, the analysts were, you know, stating their predictions for the game, and they all predicted you guys to win because on paper, you know, with FaZe only recently acquiring Kyo and only having, you know, just very few days to practice, it seems to have been an easy choice for you guys. But the game itself was actually really, really close. So just walk us through what happened.
Yeah, we knew they were going to play as a mix because obviously they're a new roster as a five. And they were just solid. I think that was the point to say. They were just five solid players on the server, and they just lacked of practice together, obviously. And yeah, they made it very complicated for us when they were T. They were very dynamic, and they were playing on our weaknesses because obviously Kyo knows how we play. So yeah, it was all in all a tie game. And what's missing for them is obviously practice, as I said before, and. They will get much better. They show that they are a good team together now, and they just need to put their talent they have into like the same objective and looking toward the same point, and that would be good.
Now, speaking about Envious itself, obviously you guys had that high when you were the champions at Kaluge, and then you were champions at the game show, but since then it's sort of been this downhill. In fact, recently at the Major, you guys, you know, the first ever champions to not be able to make it out of groups, just not so good. So can you speak a little bit about what's happening with your team right now?
So we already planned to make some in-game changes, how we're going to work on the long term, because there's obviously that thing where after big losses of French teams, there's like a shuffle in the scene, and it always happened that way. So we're trying to start, we're trying to start from scratch now and really build something on the long term and try to do things like Virtus Pro or NIP that are just climbing back on every level. So we come to this event just, how can I say, not more relaxed, but without pressure, and we're just going to play 100% our game. And whether we win or lose, I mean, it wouldn't matter, obviously, but we already planned some changes after the tournament, and that's how we're going to go no matter what. So for us, yeah, obviously our results have been disastrous. We haven't been on point as a team and even individuals. So we need to find that pace. We need to find that base level that we're always going to have, much like Fnatic, that are always constantly good. And so we're working on that on the long term to, yeah, try to build that up, because that has been lacking for all of the French teams, basically all the time. So yeah, hopefully we're gonna find the good pieces, put them in the right places, and move forward and get better from there.
So my last question for you, you just talked about the long-term vision for your team, but in the short term for your next match of to make it on to the playoffs, you will have to play either VP or Tempo Storm. Now, Tempo Storm, you played them yesterday and it was a very, very close game, a 14-16 loss. And when it comes to VP, you've played them three times this year. You guys lost two times and won once, but it was always close. It was like 14-16, 13-16, things like that. So when it comes to that potential series, who are you hoping to play? Maybe Revenge?
Well, I mean, I like to have Fallen on my side and, you know, support us, so I would be happy playing VP. But yeah, I mean, if I had to pick between both, I want to play Tempo Storm because they're a very, very strong team. And we just want to prove again that we can compete at the high level. And against Tempo Storm, we completely screwed up one side and managed to have a good T side. So we have the potential. We played great, but not long enough. And so our CD side just killed the game for us. So yeah, I don't know. I personally just want to face a good team, and Tempo Storm. We have that thing against them where they beat us at Katowice. They just demolished us, and we placed a very tight series against them. So they're that team of youngsters that are just nothing to lose and everything to prove, and they're just grinding constantly. And it's kind of sad not to see them at more events, but they have a lot of potential. And I would be happy facing them to just test ourselves.
All right, well, thank you very much, MBK. Always a pleasure doing interviews with you. Of course, we're going to go to a short commercial break, but when we come back, I'm sure the analysts have a lot to say about that game.